Why do planets only orbit the sun in a certain disk? What we can observe is that all planets are lined up and orbiting around the sun in a certain disk. We do not see a planet which, for example, orbiting the sun around its poles. The answer to this question lies within how a star or the sun formed and has something to do with the law of angular momentum conservation. How do stars form in general? They form from a molecular cloud, where there are a lot of particles, molecules in there. They're moving randomly around. But with time, maybe this cloud is starting to cool down a little. So there will be a few particles which clump together. And those clumps will attract even more particles. And with time, this region will form a potential which attracts even more particles, and those little mass clump here will collapse under its own gravity. What happened next? So we have like this inner region which is getting hotter and denser, and the particles will like fall down on it, will like hit it here, another particle comes from this direction, etc. There is no other force than the gravitation at work here. But maybe at this side there are two particles hitting here, and only on this side only one. So this thing will start to get a little impulse from this direction. And the law of angular momentum conservation tells us that if there is an impulse in a system which start from the first second, something is start to rotate a little, the angular momentum is conserved forever if there is no other force which acts against this movement. So this tiny little region will start to rotate slowly. And what we know about rotation and angular momentum can be shown in an easy example. For example, let's imagine a ballet dancer or a figure skater rotating. He or she will rotate with a speed, the hands far within the body. If this person are pulling their arms through the body, their rotation will speed up immediately. And this is exactly what angular momentum conservation says. The closer to the center where the rotation is happening, the stronger is the velocity. How is this now important for our solar system or with the formation of a star at all? We have now this denser, hotter region in the middle. And we have the two forces, the gravitation, which wants to make this star or the cloud even collapse more. And we have this rotation and the angular conserved. So with this rotation, there is the centrifugal force, which is pulling the particles out. And the gravitation, which works in the other direction. So all the molecules around here, they will be either forced away from the centrifugal craft or attracted to the middle. And they only can be around a certain disk, because this will be the stable, balanced system they can be. And now, why the planets form this disk? Because they have no other choice, because they get like forced around this disk, around the proto star. For example, here. There will be a bulgy thing in the middle, and then there will be a disk-like thing in the outer skirt. And we do not only experience that with stars, we also see that, for example, with galaxies. This galaxy is rotating very fast, and all the stars are like located around a disk. So from this part of the formation of the planetary system, like this outer part will get cleaned out. The planets, which are like new, like clumper systems, like moving around the disk, will like get more and more material, until the whole disk is cleaned out and we only find something like this. Like when you see here from the picture from the top, like the star in the middle and the planets moving around here in the disk in certain orbits, they cleaned out all the system and only the planets stay. The rest of the material, maybe molecules and other stuff, some gas, will be eaten, like be inside these planets or in the atmosphere of these planets or driven away. When you look on edge, you see that the star here is in the middle and all the planets are lined up. Because of the law of angular momentum conservation, all the planets are forced to stay around the disk.